In this video, I'm going to be sharing with you 10 apps for sim racers, whether you're starting out or you've been sim racing for many, many years. Now, I know what you're thinking, not another video that's going to talk about CrewChief or SimHub. But yes, for those that aren't familiar with those apps, I will be just quickly showing those. But stick around because I guarantee you there's one or two here you haven't come across yet. Anyway, with that said, let's get into it. First up is SimHub. Now, for those that don't know, SimHub is a great application which allows you to add and configure hardware to connect to your sims. So hardware such as butt kickers, dedicated display units, DDUs, wind sims, button boxes, and so many more. On top of that, it has a great dash studio where you can install and use car dashboards to display on a phone, on a tablet, on a secondary monitor, or on a DDU. Now, SimHub is free, but there is also a licensed version. And what's great about this is not only can you choose the license price you want to pay, but it also unlocks other features for you, such as you can drive all your Arduinos, your displays and your shakers at 60 FPS instead of a limited 10 FPS. There's automatic game switching. You can even set it to start minimized when Windows boots up, so it's not sort of there all over the screen, which is really good. Now, installation is fairly straightforward with an installer that pretty much does everything for you. Next up is CrewChief, and CrewChief is a free virtual spotter and a crew chief that provides crucial vocal updates on everything that's happening within a race. Information such as lap times, race standings, gaps between the car in front and the car behind, whether those gaps are increasing or decreasing. It also provides valuable information on the condition of the car, such as how badly damaged it is, tire pressures, tire temperatures, brake temperatures. It even tells you the track temperature. One of the most useful aspects of CrewChief is the proximity warnings, and it tells you constantly where close cars are in relation to you. Now, there's even a very popular profanity setting where CrewChief can use rather colorful language to motivate you, let's say. Now, it isn't enabled by default, but just be careful if you have kids around. Now, it supports most sim titles, ACI Racing, R-Factor 2, AMS 2. It supports the F1 franchise and ACC, although some features aren't available for those. Dirt Rally 1, Dirt Rally 2, Race Room, and so many more. Now, installation is fairly simple with an installer that does all the hard work for you, and all the information you'll ever need on CrewChief can be found over at the CrewChief website. Now, next up is CrewChief Auto Start, which is a free application you can get from Race Department. So for those that haven't heard of this one, this application will auto start CrewChief based on what sim titles you enable it for. So as an example, you might want to use it to launch CrewChief automatically when you load HeliCorsa, but not maybe when you load ACC. And with this app, you can do just that. You don't have to now remember to start CrewChief anymore. No more jumping in the game, hitting start, hitting drive, and then realizing, I didn't start CrewChief. There's a configuration file that comes with this. It's a simple ini file, and inside here you can edit and choose what sims it can monitor and what not. Now, even though this app hasn't had an update in over 3 years, I find that this still works really, really well. To install it, simply download it from Race Department, place the contents of the zip file in a folder of your choosing. I've put mine on the desktop. And then in that folder, if you right click and choose create shortcut on the exe, then all you need to do is put this shortcut in your Windows startup folder, and then whenever Windows runs, this will start automatically for you, and then it will monitor the sims you have it configured for. Next up is RaceLab Apps, and these are a set of beautifully designed, very clean, very minimalistic overlays which you can drag and drop around the screen or screens and put in whatever position you like. Now, we have overlays such as standings, we have a relative overlay, fuel calculator, we have an input telemetry overlay, we have a track map, we have head-to-head, we have a flat map, we have flags, we have data blocks, we have a radar overlay, pit box helper, and many, many more. Now, currently, RaceLab Apps only supports ACC, iRacing, R-Factor 2, or the F1 game franchises. And if you drive any of these, I can highly recommend them. Now, there is a free version of RaceLab Apps with basic features and customization, but the paid version unlocks everything, and it will only cost you €3.90 per month. Next up is Lovely Dashboard. And for those that don't know about Lovely Dashboard, it's a custom designed dashboard, car dashboard, which you can use to display a dashboard on a dedicated display unit, a DDU, on a tablet, on a phone, or on an additional monitor. The dashboard will show you all the information you need to see from the car and the track. Information such as what gear you're in, tire pressures, tire temps, brake temps, how much fuel you have on board, how much fuel you're using, how many laps of fuel you have left, wind speed, track temps, and so much more. I did a review recently, so if you want to know where to get this, how to install it, how to configure it, and how to use it, check the link down in the description below. Next up is a radar app, and the one that you're seeing on screen is HeliCorsa for Assetto Corsa. Again, all links will be down in the description below. This is a proximity indicator showing you a bird's eye view of your car and those cars around you and how close they are. It's very useful for avoiding any collisions with maybe cars you didn't see or someone trying that desperate dive up the inside coming from miles behind you. It can literally save your race for you by helping you to avoid everything that literally could end it. Now ACC has one built into it and so does AMS2, but if you want to change things up a little bit, RaceLab has also got you covered with a built-in radar overlay. Next up is a fuel calculator. Now there's a few fuel calculators, easy for me to say, out there, and there's also specific apps for specific sims. Now as I mentioned earlier, RaceLab have a fuel calculator overlay, which is great in my opinion. But as I mentioned, it only supports ACC, iRacing, R-Factor 2 or the F1 games. But also, as I mentioned previously, Lovely Dashboard tells you how much fuel you're using, how much fuel is left, how many laps of fuel you have left. And as I also mentioned, it does support every sim title and is free. Next up is a relatives board, and again, RaceLab has you covered here if you are into iRacing, R-Factor 2, ACC and the F1 game franchise. But if you're not driving one of these titles, again, Lovely Dashboard has this covered off so well. Next, in number 9, it's a Coach Dave Academy application called Delta. Now, if you're looking for some really, really good setups, some tried and tested setups for ACC or iRacing, then Delta is the app for you. Now, what Delta does is it automatically loads the setups, the custom setups for the exact car and for the exact track based on what you've already chosen in the game. And then when you click on the load button within ACC, you'll see that the setups are listed there for you. So you will have setups for qualifying, setups for race, setups for dry, setups for wet, and you just simply choose the one that you want and away you go. Now the Delta app is free itself, but you have to have a paid subscription to the Coach Dave Academy for the actual setups. Now there are monthly and annual billing plans. The monthly plan is just shy of €10. So if you want setups for iRacing, it will cost you €9.99. If you want ACC as well, that will cost you an additional €9.99. And the annual pricing plan is currently €99 a year each. Now for this price, you don't just get the ACC setups and the iRacing setups. You also get the MoTeC data download, which allows you to download the telemetry information so you can analyze it in the MoTeC app. It comes with tire pressure management, fuel management. They have some planned updates coming, so soon iRacing is going to support the auto setup installs. There's a planned MFD control in ACC coming, SimGrid calendar sync coming, LFM calendar sync, and much more. Next up is my favorite app for VR, and this is HoloSwitch. Now, HoloSwitch basically sends notifications from your phone straight to your VR headset. Now, I know what you're thinking. I'm on for a lap record around the Nordschleife. Why do I want to receive a text message from my mate Dave, who's sending me a picture of a cat? But hear me out. With this app, you can choose which notifications you want to get from which app. So what I use this for is, if I'm home alone and I'm expecting a delivery, I can configure this app to send notifications from my doorbell straight into my VR headset so I never miss that delivery again. But wait, that's not the best bit. The best bit is, if the wife's out and I'm babysitting, I can still jump in the rig when my daughter's asleep next door. And if there's a noise detected from her baby monitor, it will instantly send a notification to the VR headset and I can go and help her find that soft toy that she's lost. Now, currently, it only works with Android phones. There was an iPhone app. I was a beta tester for the iPhone app, but it looks like it's been removed. But having said that, Android devices are far cheaper than Apple devices nowadays. And because this is just a killer app in VR, I've decided to leave this in the list. Now, one of the other insane features of this app is something called Peephole. And what that allows you to do is to use your phone's camera as a little sort of surveillance device. So you can prop it up in the room, put your VR headset on. So no more screaming when someone taps you on the shoulder to grab your attention. You can just see them coming. So let me know down in the comments below if this was of any use to you. I hope it was. And if you're new to sim racing, check out the video that's showing on screen now, which talks about what sim racing hardware to purchase, what order to purchase it in, and what mistakes to avoid. Catch you in the next one.